complete online registration in LGNISD for a new student, please complete the following steps. First off, make sure you have a current parent portal account set up within your name. Proceed to log in with your made username and password. Once signed in, click on the Enroll New Student button in the green box. Proceed to the steps as indicated. On step one, enter the student's first name, middle name, if there is one, and last name. Enter the CAPTCHA, click continue, and then continue one more time. To continue the enrollment process, add family address. You may add to 1 to 4 family addresses, with at least one being entered. After entering the physical address, you may click on the blue box to copy the physical address into the mailing address sections if they are the same. If not, enter the mailing address as well. Once complete, click Save Changes. You may add a second address. Again, up to 4 addresses may be added if needed. Second, add family contacts. These are going to be contacts that you can use for emergency numbers or ride pickups or any other form of contact you may need for the school to get a hold of you. Add as many contacts as possible to provide adequate support and communication between parents and guardians and the school. Not all boxes are required, but do at least complete the required ones to add a contact. And again, as the address is populated, you may click on the blue address if it is the same as listed above in the student information. Continue to add family contacts until all contacts have been entered. Again, the more contacts that have been inputted, the better the school will be able to communicate. Once you have finalized the family contact, click Continue to go on to Step 4. In Step 4, click on Edit Student Information to edit the information for that student, specifically the name, the contact information, things like birth dates, and other information. Be sure to mark which one is the primary contact and continue to add information as requested. Again, some information is optional, but any information that is required will end up with a red box around it. Once complete, click Save and Continue to move on to Step 5. On Step 5, you will see downloadable enrollment forms. These forms include things like the parent-student handbook and the student code of conduct. These forms are downloadable at this time, but also are available on the district website at any time. As you go through the forms, be sure to click Save Changes. All forms must be reviewed, and after clicking Save Changes, you will need to close that specific box. Forms are done when the exclamation point changes into a check mark. On the ethnicity and race page, be sure to include both your ethnicity and your race. More than one race may be chosen. Under the residency questionnaire, if the first two questions are answered no, then you may skip to the bottom of the page and click Submit. If either of the first two answers are yes, complete the rest of the information and then click Save Changes. Again, on the Migrant Education Program section, if the first two sections you answered no, you may continue onto the bottom of the page to submit. If you answer yes on either question, be sure to complete all questions within this section. Continue to view and save changes on each required enrollment form. In the special education status, the first question, the above named student has never received special education services. Mark true if the student is not in special education or receives special education services, and continue to save and changes. If they have received special education services ever, click false, and continue to answer the questions. On the home language survey, be sure to mark only one type of language on questions 1 and 2. For instance, do not write both English and Spanish if both languages are spoken at home. Only choose one of the main languages. Under the food allergy section, if your student has any allergies, please list those here and the reaction that may be seen. If no food allergies are present, be sure to sign your name at the bottom of the page, including your phone number, and click Save Changes. Under the Student Directory Information Release, these are LGNISD-specific directory information pieces. The first question specifically is asking about participation in media release. These will include things like yearbook, staff information, and newsletters. By clicking No, your student will not be included in these. But by clicking Yes, it does allow for those things to occur. In the Student Media Release section, this is for any non-LGNISD media information. For example, if a news program comes to interview your student, will you allow this to occur? Make your selection and click Save Changes. Once you've completed all requirement documents, click Submit to District. Go back into your email, and you should receive a confirmation email of your student enrollment. Once you see this email, you may go back into the enrollment forms, click Continue to Final Step. At this time, if you have more students to enroll, you can click the button Add Another Student. If this is your last student, click Print Enrollment Confirmation, and you have completed enrollment. That enrollment confirmation needs to come with the required documentations for residency verification, any of the documents, to the school's registrar to complete registration.